Shri Krishna at Govardhanagiri. One day, Shri Krishna and Balarama noticed that all the village folk of Vrindavan were very busy making great preparations, presumably for a great sacrifice. Perhaps Shri Krishna wanted to teach them the Vedantic truth. Na karmana amritatva manashuhu. Liberation is not obtained as a fruit of action. He approached Nanda, his foster father, and the headman, and made inquiries. Father, what is all this great flutter about? What are you attempting at? Please let me know it. An action performed after due deliberations bestows best results and will be in any way much better than actions performed thoughtlessly. Further, if there is any secret about it, it will gain greater value if it is shared with friends and well-wishers. No doubt it should not be divulged to enemies or evil-minded people. It's evident that you are going for a great sacrifice. Please let me know what is it. What is the net result you expect out of the sacrifice? Who is the God that you propose to propitiate? What are the requirements of the sacrifice? Is that sacrifice a scientific undertaking ordained by the Shastras or a local custom? Let us discuss and come to a decision before we spend much materials on this. Nanda replied, Indra is the lord of the clouds. The clouds are his army. He is very fond of them. The clouds give us rain. Rain produces plenty of food through crops and supplies water for our sustenance. Thus, rain bestows happiness to humanity. By plenty of food and water, the three aspirations of man, Dharma, Artha and Kama, are fulfilled. So we worship God Indra so that when he is pleased, he will give timely rains and that too in plenty. This has become a custom in our Vraja. If we do not worship him, Indra will be angry. We will not be reaping good results. The seasons will be a failure. If we worship Indra with this Indra Yaga, Indra will be pleased. If Indra is pleased, there will be plenty of rains. With plenty of rains, there will be plenty of fodder in the pasture lands. With plenty of fodder, cows will yield plenty of milk, which will give us plenty of curds, butter and ghee. With these, we will be able to perform sacrifices to gods again and again. Hearing this reply, Shri Krishna, the Lord, scoffed at the idea just to put down the pride of Indra and replied, Father, every soul is born on account of its past action, karma. By action it thrives and by its own actions it perishes. It is the individual efforts that cause or produce one's pain or pleasure, prosperity or poverty. If there is a Lord controlling activities in the world, he too will judge one according to one's actions. There can be no judgment of his on one who does not act. Meaning, a lazy man gets no fruits. A jnani who is beyond actions does not reap any fruits. Therefore, it is one's own actions that rule the destinies of life for every individual. If one performs all good actions only, he reaps great fruits. If one does only bad actions, he will reap only evil fruit out of them. So it is action, karma, which is the controller of all our destinies. Then where is there scope for Indra to interfere in this affair? If one discharges his dharma, the result will be to his benefit. If we leave off our dharma, nobody is going to protect us. So let us mind our dharma. We prosper by our cattle. The cattle live by the pasture. The pasture lands thrive by the rains. We get rain because of the rich hills and forests. We live in these forest lands, not in cities or town. Let us therefore worship the hills and forests. Let us feed the cows in plenty. Let Brahmins perform fire sacrifices in this regard. Let all living creatures be sumptuously fed, men or animals. Then let us worship and go round the hill, which is our deity. That will be our real worship. It will please all and it will be particularly pleasing to me, the Lord. Accordingly, all the materials collected for the Indrayaga were utilized for worshipping the hill. Achala puja was conducted by Nanda and all the elderly folk to that hill, which thereafter was called Govardhanagiri. Brahmins conducted fire sacrifices with plenty of ghee. The cows were fed with plenty of grass. A grand feast was given for everybody assembled there. As the worship was being offered to the hill, the Lord himself took the form of the hill and consumed all the offerings to the great joy of the devotees. Sri Krishna was one among those who were making the offerings. He was receiving them in the form of the hill. And it was he who pointed out to the other devotees saying, "Look here, how blessed are we. The hill Govardhanagiri is pleased to swallow all our offerings. We have done well to worship him. Otherwise, he would punish those evildoers who do not worship him." After the worship was over, all of them went round the hill with music and bhajan and then returned to Vraja. A hill or mountain is known as Achala, which means motionless or immovable. Achala is one of the attributes of the infinite Brahman. He is Achala Paripurna. Therefore, here the worship of the hill, Achala, is only the worship of the infinite in the shape of Sri Krishna, which worship the gopas and gopis were initiated by Sri Krishna himself. Thus, they were shown the higher goal than worshipping of Indra, the mind, which is very fickle, never steady, therefore chanchala. Indra, king of Devas, came to know that the annual sacrifice intended for him did not come off in Vraja due to mainly to the arrogance and prosperity of the cowherds. He thought, "They have listened to the advice of the mischievous young boy Sri Krishna and discarded me as unimportant. I will show them my power and duty, unduly punish them." He called all the strong clouds at his command and directed them to pour hailstorm on Vraja and destroy the cowherds. So before the festivity could end in the village, dark clouds spread over the sky. Strong winds began to blow. Heavy rain began to pour in all of a sudden. It developed into storm and hailstones. All the village folk beseeched Sri Krishna for protection against the sudden danger that had developed. Sri Krishna, as per his declared word of promise, "Sarvadharman parityajya mamekam saranam vraja, aham tva sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami ma suchaha," decided to protect those who sought refuge in him. A little while ago, he had taken the form of the hill and received all their offerings. Now he raised the same hill with his hands and supported it with one hand. As a boar, he had lifted the whole earth. What is a hill for him? He called all the people of Vraja, young and old, with all their cattle, to come and take shelter under the hill. He promised them that even if there were to be a deluge, his hand would not shake, and so asked them all to come near without any fear or suspicion. All the cowherd folk moved themselves under the hill, driving in all their cattle. With great relief, they remained under the hill and did not think of food or water. Rain and storm, hailstones and winds increased in vehemence. There were floods all round. The forest was shaking. 7 days it rained uninterruptedly without any results. Indra was disgusted. He realized that his power was useless against the might of Sri Krishna. The rains stopped. The sky became clear. The floods receded. There was immense peace. Birds began to fly about. Shri Krishna called out all the folk under the hill to clear away, since the rain had stopped. The cowherds moved out, driving their cattle before them. When the last man and animal was out, Shri Krishna replaced the hill in its own place and joined the cowherds and returned to Vraja. The cows and calves began to run about and jump in their joy of relief. The gods, angels and other celestials showered flowers on Shri Krishna. The old folk began to praise the great achievements of Shri Krishna. Yashoda and Rohini embraced him. There was unmixed joy everywhere. At night, all the elderly folk of Vraja surrounded Nanda and began to narrate the superhuman achievements of Shri Krishna and expressed their wonder and admiration. As a boy, he killed Putana by sucking out her life through her breasts, kicked Sakatasura, strangled Trinavarta. He killed the demon Vatsasura. He fell down the two Arjuna trees even while crawling. He destroyed Bakasura, Aghasura and Pralamba. He drove away the deadly serpent Kaliya and made the water of Kalindi available for men and animals. With a single hand, he lifted and supported the hill like a lotus and saved us and our cattle from the ravages of the storm for 7 days. Really, we cannot believe Shri Krishna to be an ordinary human boy. Nanda informed them what sage Garga had told him long before, that Shri Krishna was the infinite Brahman, born there only to destroy the wicked and to protect the good. So they were advised to discard all misconceptions about him. Indra felt piteously humiliated. All his pride disappeared. He had heard of the greatness of Shri Krishna, but now he actually witnessed and experienced his greatness. Being ashamed of himself, he sought the good offices of the celestial cow, Surabhi, and followed behind her to where Shri Krishna was, to pray for forgiveness. When Shri Krishna put on a smiling face on seeing the celestial cow, Indra stepped in and fell at his feet and prayed for pardon. He began to praise the Lord and said, "O Lord, you are pure sattva, unmixed with rajas or tamas. The universe is a product of your maya. That maya cannot affect you. I am ignorant. Because of ignorance, I was arrogant. I was proud of my sway over the three worlds. You are the Brahman, the Purusha. You are born to punish the wicked and protect the good. My pride has been crushed by your performance. I am fallen. I fall at your lotus feet. Please forgive me and protect me. I will never more disobey your dictates. I surrender to you for mercy." Shri Krishna was much pleased with Indra and said, "It was to shower my grace on you that I had interrupted the sacrifice intended for you. I wanted you to be rid of your pride. Now you realize your duties and abide by them. Know you that there is one above you who is the controller. Be righteous in your duties. Be obedient to me, the Supreme. Do not develop pride again. You will beget all auspiciousness. You may now go." Surabhi, the celestial cow, rained her milk on Shri Krishna. Indra showered celestial Ganges water, which his elephant Airavata had carried all the way in its trunk. Indra proclaimed Shri Krishna to be Govinda, the delight of the cows, and he went away with Surabhi and the other celestials. Vraja flourished with cows and milk, the forests and hills with plenty of leaves, flowers, fruit and honey. The fields yielded large crops.